There's the rear tire right there. Shift in. Tire size is 160-60R14C with a class of H high speed class tire. So get back to you as soon as I remove the rear. You got to remove that rear cover right there. That comes off. Nothing else will fall off of that except the cover. Once you have the cover off, you go on the other side, remove the cotter pin nut that's on the other side. Take the cotter pin off, remove the giant nut, and the whole stud comes out this way towards me. You pull the stud out, let's say on this side. Stud comes all the way out, drop it, pull the rear rim towards the passenger side, and it drops down. Supposedly, that easy. However, I believe you have to remove all of the brake hardware, the brake, what holds the brake the brake caliper on, the hardware that holds the brake caliper on. You got to remove all that, get the brakes out of your way, you know, just let them dangle. That way you can pull it out and out of the underneath. Now, if I have to lift it up higher, what I'm going to do is use the same method right here, but I'm going to come right up. I'm going to come right up against this. So I have this all the way up front. Now I'm going to come up against these guys here. I'm going to be starting on the other side. Let's get you walked over. That's the side I am starting on. And I cannot, you know, do this in all context. It's the wrong way. And if you look, I have to twist you to the side a little bit to make you understand what I mean by the brakes. All this has to be removed. This part right here, these two got to come off first, then these two bolts here, they come off, and then there's your whole swing arm here. It allows it to pull out this way. All right, let me get back to you in a little bit. All right, here's what you got to do. I didn't think there was enough room down there, and it, so what you got to do is get your rear tire on one block this way. A 2-inch block is fine, whatever that is. I don't know what that is. I think that's 2 inches. Ride your tire up on it. If you can't push it on by hand, start it up and gas it till it gets up there. Turn it off, hit your side kickstand, because it's going to be a lot taller. And what you want to do is inch it forward, put your cross block across this way like a T, make it like a T, and check your kickstand, your center kickstand check, bring it down to see if it's hitting that block. If it's hitting that block while the back tire is on the block, you'll be able to pull the whole bike up and stand it up on the 2-inch higher off the ground. So now we got a total of something like 3 to 4 inches off the ground now. Going like this. flat side rooms up against this bar. Now, I should have enough room. Like that. Down she goes. Right out. Roll it back there. And tilt it. One way or the other. Get out. There you can go. There you go. There she comes. Down. Right now, I want to try this little Harbor Freight. How it does work. I'm not worn in this with ease. Off the breed, bleed. There it goes. There she is. Alright. Be right back. Going to the bench. Bring you with me in a second. Bring out the big guns now. I'm not playing with the small guns. Put some light on. I'm gonna hit it with the big guns. Hold that there. sorry, now. You know, I hate that, that that's coming the other way. That's not good. I don't like that. This is coming from here.
Thank you.
All right, the camera did shut off. I don't know if it was in while I was doing the brakes or not. But when I got back off, the camera was off. So I said dead battery. But this whole side is on.